Hi everyone, welcome to Tranquil Bojo. Let's set up August in my bullet journal. The theme for this month is peacocks. Peacocks are beautiful and elegant birds that show their entire beauty in the rain. Seeing them dance is mesmerizing. Let's start by painting a few watercolor peacocks. I will post the full watercolor tutorials for the peacock that I'm painting right now and the next peacock in the next video. I have painted these peacocks using De La Rowney watercolor tubes on Canson Montval paper in an A5 size. The main colors used here are cerulean blue, ultramarine blue, leaf green, orange, and lemon yellow. This first painting is a loose watercolor illustration of the peacock when it's dancing in the rain in its full glory, showing off all of its feathers. I painted this mostly using a wet on wet technique, where wet paint is added on wet paper. Semi-realistic depiction of the peacock on a tree. Again, this was made with mostly a wet on dry technique, where there's wet paint on dry paper. I used the same colors that I used for the previous painting, but added some black to make the shadows a little deeper. I will post the full tutorial on how I painted these peacocks in the coming few days. Once I finished painting both the peacocks and a few feathers, I scanned them onto my computer, edited them to make the blues a little brighter, and printed it out on normal paper. I didn't want to directly stick these peacocks painted on watercolor paper into my journal. The watercolor paper is very thick and hence would make my journal very bulky. So I printed it on normal paper so that I could stick it into my journal. let's start setting up August in my bullet journal. I used one of the detailed peacock for the cover page and stuck it using a glue stick. Using 4 calligraphy, I lettered out the title August. I made the downstrokes thicker on each letter without filling them in. This gave it a different look, which is not usually seen when you know 4 calligraphy. To set up the month at a glance spread, I took a few of the peacock feathers, cut them in half, and pasted them along the side of the grid of the calendar. This made it look like as if the peacock feathers were coming from behind the grid. I also did that to the bottom of the page. I then used my Pilot V5 high-tech point in 0.5mm to draw the borders or the grid of the calendar. Each box in this grid is 6 spaces wide by 6 spaces tall. Then, using a teal brush marker, I made a squiggle wherever I wanted to write the days of the week in the calendar. Using a Tombow Fudenosuke brush pen, I lettered the days, only the first letters, and then also the title, which said August at a glance. Finally, I used a deeper blue brush pen to swatch out where I wanted the numbers of the dates to be and wrote out the numbers. For the next spread, I pasted the other peacock which I had painted with a little space at the bottom to write out a quote. For the final spread before the weekly spreads, I created my habit tracker. I lettered out the heading using the same teal brush pen that I use in the monthly log and stamped out the months for all the habits that I wanted to track. I bought these stamps, the acrylic block and the stamp pad off of Amazon. Finally, for the weekly spread, I divided each page into 4 quadrants, giving 1 quadrant for each day. I drew flags to put the dates in and swatched out using one of the teal brush pens to write the day. I also made a division in each quadrant to make note of amount of time that I slept that day and the weather of each day. Wrote which week it was in and drew a hydration tracker below it. finally filled in the quote for which I had left space for. The quote says,
"If you don't fight for what you want, you don't cry for what you lost."
I finally decorated the habit tracker with a few of the feathers that I had painted. Now for the final flip through for August. Thanks guys for watching this month's plan with me. If you liked what I had done, please consider liking and subscribing, and also share my videos with everyone else.